How do you bring your external users and authenticate them into your applications, whether it's a web or mobile? We got Christer Jung from the Microsoft Identity team to show us today with Azure Active Directory B2C. Join us. Welcome back, friends, for another episode on .NET Show. Today, we're going to be talking with Christer Jung, who is a senior program manager in the CXP team on the identity division. And he specializes in Azure Active Directory B2C, which means that we'll be talking about external users coming into your application, authenticating and using your systems. So, Christer, how are you today, my friend?
I'm good. I'm all good. It's December, so we're looking forward to hard work and then some relaxation.
Well-deserved time off. Yep. March day 157, Captain's Log. And today we're talking about Azure Active Directory B2C. So in this series, we're covering anything that has to do with authentication and authorization and graph. And we have a series, so make sure to watch the whole thing. But today we're focusing specifically on Azure Active Directory B2C. So tell us, Christer, what is Azure Active Directory B2C? What should developers care?
Yeah, what is Azure B2C? And that is a very common question. That I get asked a lot. And sometimes it's not obvious that even though it shares the name with Azure AD, that it is more or less the same product. And I'm using two Lego pieces as sort of an illustration to make customers and partners aware of what it is. Mm-hmm. And if you look at the red and the blue Lego piece that I have here, that illustrates really what Azure AD B2C is all about. Because underneath you have the red piece, Azure AD, that holds the persistence and everything with users, groups, and applications, and all that stuff that we're used to with Azure AD. And this layer, you can, within this layer, you can sort of interact with the normal Graph API, read, write, delete, directory objects, do everything like that. And that is also what makes it possible to admin a B2C tenant, etc., use the portal, do the normal operations. But what makes it unique is the blue piece sitting on top, because on top we have a policy engine. And that controls the configuration, and it also exposes endpoints for interacting with B2C and the policy engine. That happens from an application where a user uses it in different devices, etc., using standard protocols like OAuth, OpenID, and SAML. It actually hits the blue piece on top to interact with it. And its job is to load the policy configuration and start to execute it in a sort of a workflow way. We call it a user journey to guide the user through a process like signing in or signing up, etc. But since you have this configuration with the blue piece sitting on top of the red piece, the policy engine is no different than a normal application. It uses the Graph API to interact with the red piece when it needs to read a user's attribute, etc., update another attribute. It has no special way of pulling up that data. So that is really the role of the policy engine. But I mean, an identity solution like this, at the end of it, what it really is about, all about, is issuing something that is useful to the application, and that is a JWT token or a SAML assertion. So from an application perspective, the user does something in the application and wants to sign in. It interacts via the protocols towards the policy engine. The policy engine executes the configuration, and at the end of it, issues a token or an assertion.
Okay. So when do I use Azure AD, and when do I use Azure AD B2C? Like if I'm new to identity and I don't know where to get started, how do I make the decision?
Good question. And Azure AD B2C. B2C stands for business to consumers. Mm-hmm. So that sort of gives it away that we're talking about consumers here, but not sort of the collaboration suite that we have for other products. but it's not just consumers. It can be a combination where your online service is supporting an area where consumers log in, but we also have we have employees signing in also. So it doesn't have to be just consumers. What you can't do, what you can't do is take this token and go to SharePoint, Teams, and Outlook and try to use it, because it's geared towards the application that you create, not the existing collaboration suite.
Right. So if I'm building a website that is for like a forum for my friends to sign in, if I'm building a mobile app and I need my users to come in and, you know, create a profile and manage that profile, then B2C is where I need to go, right?
Exactly. And then you can federate with other identity providers to enable different ways of signing in, so you can follow the concept of bring your own identity, et cetera.
Like social media accounts.
Exactly. Social media accounts, popular ones, and even accounts that exist in different geographies in the world. As long as they use the open standard protocols, we can probably federate with them and integrate. So we can help you in the market and in the region that you're working with your business.
Nice.
But should we have a look at this?
Yeah, I mean, showing code and seeing that in action is probably better than talking about it. So let's do it.
Yes. Let's do it. And the Azure B2C portal, you'll find it at the Blade, you'll find it in the Azure portal.
Okay.
It looks very much like the Azure AD Blade, and some things are overlaid. So you see you have app registration and users. Mm-hmm. That is the same thing you can do when you manage Azure AD. And that's because, mm-hmm. I mean, the red piece and the blue piece, they all work with the underlying tenant.
Right.
But then comes something down here, the policies. That is mm-hmm. what the blue piece is actually loading. It comes in and it comes in two flavors, user flows and identity experience framework. And if you think those names are kind of hard to understand, think of it as basic or advanced.
Okay.
With the user flows, it's sort of click in the portal, next mm-hmm. finish. Mm-hmm. I can create a user flow to say, what should it do? It should allow me to do combined sign up, sign in, et cetera, split mm-hmm. it into just sign up or just a simple sign in. So I can create that. And then when I have one like I have here, mm-hmm. I can go in and I can say, load. Yeah, I can configure to say, what identity providers do I want to expose here, federated ones, et cetera. What claims do I want to admit, display name, given name, et cetera, mm-hmm. So that I can sort of make sure that the token I emit, that it looks the way it should. I even have more properties here, like advanced features, like do I want JavaScript to be available when this thing executes? Mm-hmm. Here you have, and do I want MFA to be enabled?
Right.
I have disabled MFA and enabled JavaScript. Mm-hmm. I've also tweaked down here the lifetime of the token, because when I demo this, I don't want to wait for 60 minutes for it to time out to show refresh tokens, etc.
Sure.
Then what you also can do we're still in the basic version here.
Okay.
In page layouts, you can do some pretty advanced stuff. You see down here, it says use custom page content.
Right.
I can live with the standard one that Microsoft provides, where I can say, no, I can do this better and paste in my own HTML to say that this is what I want, and save it. And in the portal,
that customizes the page to look and feel like your application, so users don't feel like they're leaving your app, going somewhere else and coming back, even though it's still federated and delegated to the identity provider, right?
Exactly. And in this HTML page, I can bring in the style sheets and whatever. And since I enabled JavaScript, I can mm-hmm. I can have a go at a lot of things.
Nice.
So what I was planning to do now is to show you this in working. I'm going to spin up a little Node.js API in the background here. I'll keep it around just so you can see that it's actually doing something.
Okay.
And in another window, another Node app, I'm going to spin up a web app.
Mm-hmm.
Here you have it, but I'll close that one down because it's not that interesting. And let's
have find a look an interesting at, one. Yes.
Yep. Let's have a look at B2C in action. So if I go to localhost 3000, and this is, by the way, it's the standards web apps we have, MCell, browser, spa apps, samples we have. Okay. The only thing I've done is I've tweaked it a little bit with these buttons so we can have an exercise with it. And I've enabled two calls here, the standard sample calls Graph API, but I'm going to call the this guy that sits in the background here to do my own APIs. So I picked a picture of the moon as background here. That's because the style I'm using in the B2C sign-in page that I have has the same experience. So if I had my own company's background, et cetera, I could use that one. I just picked the moon. And as you can see, the reason why I brought is the customized background is because I may want to edit something like terms and conditions or whatever. Oops, that was bad. Don't do that. Terms and conditions in the back so that I have got custom messages, etc. I'm just going to sign in here with a local account that I already created. And what happens is, this is an identity provider like any other. On the return, I got an ID token that tells the application who am I, and I've got an access token that I can play with. So I can call the API, and we'll see something is happening in the back end here. It validates the token I've got, and it echoes back to say, whoops, you had the right to call me.
Right. So what we have here is a front-end web app written with JavaScript that authenticates the user against the Azure Active Directory B2C. It acquires the appropriate token, and then it also gets an access token to go and call an API that is also protected by Azure Directory B2C.
Correct.
And it works end-to-end. Brilliant.
Yeah. And then how all this interaction works is if I need another token, I'm going to call another API in this process in the background. I don't have the right API access token yet because it's not in the list. But when I press this one, it's going to silently talk to B2C to say, can I get this access token? And nothing will be shown in the user interface because it happens all in the background. I'm already authenticated. You see I have the right token now. Mm-hmm. And when I press, let's see if I can make this smaller. When I press this button, things happen in the API window. It passes the access token, and I'm validated that I have the proper access.
So, perfect.
Yep. There you have it. This is Azure AD B2C.
And we are using MCell, right? So whichever language you're using, MCell, which is the Microsoft Authentication Library, still works with both Azure Active Directory and Azure AD B2C. So we don't have to change the code, just the endpoints.
You don't have to change the code. You can just change them.
Sweet.
If we take a look at just, this works on multiple devices. So let's see if we can start the MCell, the Xamarin version that uses B2C.
So we have web, and now we're using this similar code inside a Xamarin app or a mobile app that runs for both iOS and Android. Very nice.
Because you want a solution that works on all devices and platforms. So let's see if Oops, it's probably in the background. Starting the simulator.
Yep.
And I need to drag it to the right window like this.
And I think B2C now also has added capabilities for two-factor authentication, right? So you don't have to, you get the added benefit of extra security without you as a developer having to roll that out yourself.
Exactly. With the advanced features, we do add features in the user flow in the basic one as we go along. But with advanced features, you can start adding whatever you can sort of almost dream up.
Very nice.
So in the phone experience would be something like this. We're talking to B2C, it loads the policy. And I mean, you don't need to use email to sign in. You can define whatever you like and assume that this is this would be a loyalty number or something in your membership club.
You could use nice.
that. You, could, You can use that as user ID and sign into the same account.
Sign in with Apple and Facebook. These are external providers that we integrate with, so you don't have to use a username and password or your phone or your loyalty card. You can use an external account. Brilliant.
Exactly. And then you have the tokens in the phone app, and you can start sort of calling the APIs and do whatever your application needs to do on a mobile phone.
There you have it. And end-to-end.
Yep.
Brilliant. Well, thank you very much, Krista. That was really educating. And it's great to see that, you know, with the same code, MSOL, the same library, I can call Azure AD if I need to do line of business apps, or if I'm creating an app for external users, not in my organization, and or more advanced scenarios, then I can use Azure Active Directory B2C. And I think we have docs and samples for people to go and use and look at for next steps.
Yep,
I think all the code is also in GitHub, right?
Yeah, on GitHub, we have a community sample, and I think we're up to close to 40 different samples, how to implement different things like FIDO, you said there. It's doing email-based invites. It's how to do remote profiling, how to use the authenticator. Everything you can think of is probably there. If not, we can create it for you.
We can reach out to you, and you'll write it for us. Perfect.
Yep.
This was another great episode on the On.NET show. We had Krista to show us all about Azure Active Directory B2C. Thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you on the next episodes.